We're fixing to be. When the time
is. Rotate your device.
Rotate your device.
I don't want to rotate my device. You should be live. Hey, everybody.
Hello.
Hello.
Say hey, Donnie.
Hey.
Hey, Donnie.
It's a higher calling from Pensacola, Florida, and we've come to be your entertainment tonight, be your blessing.
We're not going to entertain.
And I hope you enjoy our program.
Yes.
Our ministry program.
Yes.
Yes.
We prayed. Hope you all prayed. So we're going to open up with a scripture for today. Look, if you got your Bibles, in Psalm 61. Verse 2 says, from the end of the earth I will cry to you when my heart is overwhelmed. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I. So we're going to lead you to the rock. And that rock, everybody say who it is?
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus Christ of Nazareth. He's our rock through all this stuff we're going through.
Amen.
So we're going to open up with a song. I used to call it my dentist song, you know. I went to the dentist today and got a feeling. I got a feeling everything's going to be all right.
Oh, yeah.
What we got is everything is going to be all right, folks. I hope this song will bless you.
Tell them all to start making comments where we will know they're there.
Make sure we're on. You got to make a comment so we know we're on.
Don't miss the song.
Maybe just talking to ourselves.
Hello. Here we go.
Come on. Sheila.
To lead his people out.
Woo!
Pharaoh's heart was hard and he thought he'd give them right. So he led them all down to the Red Sea shore. Thought he wouldn't worry about Moses anymore. But Moses stretched his rod out over the sea. And God sent a message with a little gentle breeze. I can see Moses now, smile on his face. Lead his people cross with his gentle grace.
Said, I got a feeling. Everything's gonna be alright. Oh, oh, I got a feeling. Everything's gonna be alright. Well, oh, I got a feeling. Everything's gonna be alright. It'll be alright. It'll be alright. It'll be alright.
A little boy named David went out to fight a giant. People there thought it was such a funny sight. Little shepherd boy on with only a sling. Next to mighty Goliath seemed like such a puny thing. But David said, you come to me with a spear and a sword, but I come to you in the name of the Lord.
Hey.
So he put a stone in, he gave it a flame.
Oh, yeah.
And when he left his hands, he began to sing.
I got a feeling everything's gonna be alright.
Of them all.
Oh, yeah.
Jesus was a dying and hell had a ball. All the demons were rejoicing. They thought they won the war, but soon they wouldn't be laughing anymore. On that first Easter morning when the sun woke up the earth, the cavern of the deep opened up to give birth to a resurrected Savior with healing in his wings. And now his host of children rise and sing.
Said, I got a feeling. Everything's gonna be alright. Oh, oh, I got a feeling. Everything's gonna be alright.
Oh, yeah.
I got a feeling. Everything's gonna be alright. It'll be alright. Be alright. Be alright.
The going to be all right, just
yes,
like the song says. You know, we got a wonderful president, and we had good leadership in our country that's going to bring us through all this.
Amen. God's going to bring us through. Yes,
thank you, President Trump.
And your wife?
My wife?
Is
she on the camera?
Yes, she is. Yeah.
Janet?
And Janet is on the camera.
Come on,
and
we know.
And before we go any further, my sister Sheila McCoy is coming on the camera sometime because last week, guess what she was doing? She was trying to get us all she could, but she was on there at 10 o'clock in the evening.
Sending us messages.
Sending us messages.
We all already went home with the
bed. Yeah, she was trying her best to send us a message at 10 o'clock at night, but she couldn't do it, so we're shouting out to Sheila McCoy tonight, and also Paul Whitfield.
Oh.
That's some people that we love dearly that we want to shout out to them. And also, before we go any further, there is a prayer request.
Yes.
Yeah.
Anthony.
Go ahead.
Yes.
Yes.
Anthony,
we need to do this.
He needs prayer. Somebody called in.
Yeah.
Their son Anthony needs prayer. So everybody remember that name in your prayer. Let's get a prayer chain going over.
Yes, her son is going through difficult times. She actually took the time to text me from watching this program and requested that we pray for her son. I don't want to divulge everything because I don't want to get anything wrong.
God knows.
But God knows. Yeah. Remember Anthony.
Yes, we will do that. And everybody out there watching, please don't forget to pray for Anthony. God knows all about what's going on in this guy's life. So just call out his name, Anthony.
God will know him.
Anthony. When you pray, don't forget
Anthony. And Anthony, we're praying for you too.
Yes, yes, yes. We thank God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Well, do we want to talk about the supper club a little bit?
Oh,
talk about how we're not having it probably this month. I don't know if a lot of you realize for a while, a couple of years, it had been 2 years, this October, we've been doing a gospel music supper club at the Elks Club here in Pensacola. It's out on Highway 98 and 72nd Street, just maybe a mile down from the Navy Hospital. And we've been the fourth Saturday every month, and it's been going really well. Sometimes attendance is good and sometimes not, but the food's always been good, you know. So, but we open up. Usually we have groups coming through, good groups, I mean big groups, that just need some gas money for their bus so we can afford them, you know.
Yeah.
And they come in and play for us, and you know, and we just have a good time. It's been a good thing, but we haven't been able to do it since this virus has been going on. And we don't know when, you know, we'll be able to get back, but we'll keep you informed on that.
Most likely it'll be July before they can open up for everyone from the state. And we really want to keep it going, but we are really hoping to have something at Cross Points Church on the 27th. Chip Radke will be coming down. I don't need to be saying this. We'll have a guest later on the show.
Yeah,
right.
We got somebody going to be saying all this.
Okay.
So
yeah, but the supper club.
That's not Christmas. That's not
Christmas. Joy bells.
That's joy
bells. Is that the next song we're going to do?
No, I got to ask Donnie something real quick. Last week, I was going to ask Donnie a secret question. And I forgot about it. So Donnie, tell us something. I was going to ask you two questions. Donnie, are you married?
The answer would have to be no.
Okay, and the second question is, Donnie, do you want to get married?
Where's your laugh button?
Okay, wait a minute. Let me tell you, Donnie, do you...
At my age, I don't see much point in it.
At your age is the point. They can cook and clean and wash for you. That is the point.
You answered the question right, Donnie. You win, Donnie. Thank you. No, I really did want to ask him those questions because there might be someone out there that's available, Donnie. You never know. You're not too old. Okay, just a punch there for Donnie. Okay, he's a wonderful songwriter, don't you think?
Oh, on the other hand, there's no telling who was out there that may not be now.
Renee, we're getting deep. Let's
okay,
sing.
Okay, let's go ahead and
let's
sing.
Let's sing a song.
Would you like to sing a song, Renee?
What is my song? Okay. All right, let's sing.
When the song about when Jesus was on the cross.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's a Pensacola song, isn't it?
Florida Boys.
Yeah.
To the cross.
Amen.
Can you say amen right where you are?
Amen.
And thank you, Lord, for giving his life for every one of us. And do you know what we're going through today? Everything that's going on out in the streets of our country, what's going on with the virus, Jesus Christ died and paid for every single one of us. Every one of us. And I thank him for that right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Karen Miller, for tuning in with us tonight. We just thank every person that's watching, and we just praise God for every body. Thank you.
Is that Carolyn Mueller?
Mueller.
Mueller, I'm sorry.
That's Terry's little sister.
I'm so sorry.
Hi, Karen.
And Barry James.
Oh, Mueller. Yeah. Hey, darling.
And Barry James.
Barry James, or?
He is a new viewer that's coming in.
Is that Barry Eanes or James?
Barry James.
Barry James.
Barry James.
Hey, Barry. Thank you so much.
He's got a fruity first name, but Barry James. Strains it right out, Barry.
Barry.
Yeah.
Barry. Oh, Barry. Don't try to figure it out.
Barry.
Go on to the next song.
Okay. All right. Praise God.
I want to ask you about something. They told me you work at a
she volunteers.
Oh, yes,
yeah,
I do.
Yeah, well, that doesn't pay anything. So
no,
it's
I
still
didn't.
Work, though.
Yeah.
I know. I volunteer. But
and you
what
know,
do you do?
Oh, and I cannot remember the name of it. Lord have mercy, Jesus. I was going to have that on hand, and I forgot. But anyway, I work for...
Is it Waterfront Rescue?
No. And next week, I will have exactly the name of this place. But it is a homeless shelter where they have showers there for the homeless people. They have meals for them. They have a post office there for the people to bring. They have get their mail there and everything. It's a wonderful, wonderful place. And I go there on Saturdays and help. I do the mail. I like that because I get to talk to people a lot. But it is a wonderful place for the homeless. I think last week we fed 297 people.
Wow.
And
That's a lot.
It really is. It really is. They're the nicest people you would ever want to meet. They are so grateful and so thankful for what is being done for them. Because I really didn't know what I was getting into. I really did not know what I was getting into. But I'll tell you, I enjoy every minute of it. And just to know these people are so grateful for what is being done for them. So I'll get the information to you next week.
Does anybody preach to them? Right? They have,
you know, I'm not really sure what all goes on. I'm just doing my part.
Well, Jesus used to like to feed people and then he preached to them.
Yeah, so there's a lot
goes on. You don't want to hear people's stomachs growling.
Yeah, but there's a lot goes on that I'm not sure of, you know. But there's a lot of people that invest.
It takes a lot of people to run a ministry like that.
It takes special people.
And food. Oh, there's food.
Can't just be one person.
Oh, no. There's food that's given by the restaurants, there's food
volunteer.
Given by the, oh yes, everything's volunteer, and it's wonderful, wonderful ministry. We'll go into
and
that.
We don't know the name of it.
It's a long
name. We'll tell you next week.
I will. Yeah. I will have all that.
Well, I have been affiliated with homeless before, and it's really a rewarding feeling when you get and
really
you can help. But the main thing is when you can see them go from that and grow and get out of it is a wonderful, wonderful, and then them come back in to serve others.
Yes.
Me and Terry, we've been homeless before. When we moved here back in 95, we didn't have a place to live.
Wow.
We went to Loaves and Fishes and stayed.
See?
We had the four little guys, and Gabe and Nathan were older. They stayed over in Louisiana with their grandparents, and I found a job. We were there 10 days.
Wow. Well, I see.
But,
what was awesome was
when we showed up here, the revival had just started.
Wow.
So them guys, they used, wasn't supposed to, but they liked me. They used to let me slip out and go to revival. So
wow.
It was like I was living in heaven, when I moved here.
That's wonderful.
Yeah,
wonderful.
Loaves and Fish, that's a good place too.
Yes.
Well, my homeless person that I've been seeing has gone, he has been with us about 10 years now. And to see the progression of his life and where he's coming out is really, really good.
Good guy.
Y'all
gonna be blessed.
He's a good guy.
He has been blessed. Danny's been blessed. They all have. Yeah. Why don't you sing something about being sealed?
Sealed till the day of redemption.
Yeah, that will work.
If you belong to Jesus, your seals. He's got his seal on you.
Amen.
Here we go.
That's what this song is about.
Praise God.
I think.
Don't you know I've been sealed till the day of redemption? One day Jesus will come and take me away, and forever will live in a beautiful mansion.
See mom and dad and stepmamas, and we're going to see family.
Praise
that
God.
Made it on
sisters,
to
aunts,
heaven,
and uncles.
Sisters, aunt, and uncle, yeah. They're going to know you.
Amen, they are.
And we're going to know them.
Amen.
We'll be known as we are known.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, I want to say, since our churches are now opened again, if you would like to invite,
I thought that was a good laugh.
I thought that was me, but I leaned on this, so that was a good laugh, wasn't it? But now that our churches are opened again, thank God, hallelujah.
Praise Lord.
If you would like to invite a higher calling to your church to sing and to minister in your church, we would love to come. We come on a love offering.
Food.
No, not food. None of us need food.
You know, churches always have food when we go to them.
I was talking. Where's my grandfather clock? Cuckoo clock.
What time is it?
I was speaking. Thank you very much.
About time to get out of here.
But anyway,
If you would like to invite us, we would love to come. So give Pat Hardy a call, Pat Cravat Hardy, a message or a call or whatever, a higher calling.
The number's right back on the side.
I'm going to cuckoo clock him for just a second. Oh, I'm saved. I'm healed. And, but anyway, that was my speaking to you after Ron's interruptions. We would love to come. We really do have a good time in the Lord. So that was my,
that was
go
fun.
Ahead.
That was fun.
Yeah,
I got
you.
Nothing to say. I just...
Well, I do. I say listen to us from 11 o'clock to 12 o'clock on WTJT 90.1. And Robert Williamson, he does such a grand job of opening our program and closing for us. We'd like to say thank you, Robert, very, very much.
90.1, that's out of Baker,
Florida. And then they have a AM, FM in...
Yeah, 1380 AM in Greenville. Alabama.
So but guess what I found out?
What'd you find out?
I found out that my friends in Italy, Germany, and the friends in the Philippines, all they have to do is go and Google WTJT.org and they can hear our program all over the world.
Cool.
It's internet radio. And it's the same call letters, WTJT, just .org, and you can get it.
Cool!
You know, you used to not be able to do that.
Nope.
Back in the 50s.
But you can
but you
now.
Can today.
You can now, so.
Am I timed out?
No, I'm waiting for Donnie to say something.
Oh.
And he wouldn't interrupt you, so I had to. So.
Maybe I should have said something way while ago.
Yeah.
It would have stopped all that.
Really? What are we going
to
say?
Yeah,
now?
We try to set you up with a date, you know.
Because it's getting time to run down. What are we going to sing?
You're going to sing God Walks the Dark Hills.
Well, I didn't know that, but anyway.
Yes, it's on, okay. On the list. Right?
Ready?
But listen, okay. Well, he does do that.
He walks the dark hills.
Okay, let's do it.
It's an old Vestal Goodman song.
God walks the dark hills, the ways of my ways. He walks on the billows of life's troubles.
the flat lands.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. That is a good song. That's a good song.
God's with us in the mountains.
Amen. Let me say something too right here, since y'all are taking a breath. I have now converting our Facebook program to YouTube. So you can now reach us, A Higher Calling, Facebook, radio, and YouTube. You go out there and you just do A Higher Calling, Pat Cravat, and it'll bring right up. And there are things that y'all have done from way on back.
Oh.
Matter of fact, we're going to do a song later on, and we've done other ones that's got over 4,000 or 5,000 hits on them. That's been going. So,
people just keep putting that dime in there.
Oh, yeah.
The old jukebox.
Put another dime in the jukebox. Yeah, they do.
Well, praise the Lord. That's wonderful. And I know that one of them is Donnie's song. I'll tell you what.
Yeah.
That, I love that. God bless.
Yeah, we've been working on a new CD, and that we got a new song that Donnie's done.
Yeah.
I forgot the name of that song.
Unfortunately, I have more than one song, and some of them get confused.
Oh, don't change it. You know what we're talking about.
I know, yeah. But we did it, and Guy Heath is helping produce it. But it's really a neat song. I think Derek Barnes played on it some, and then we got a Dixieland sound to it.
Yeah,
that's what we're going to do next.
Lucky Kelson, Lucky Studio.
Lucky Studio on Government Street in Pensacola, Florida.
It was Guy Heath's idea. He said, that sounds like it needs a big band sound, a Dixieland band sound. So
yeah.
That's where they got those horns.
Yeah. Yeah. So we got this right here. I think.
What is that?
Well, I'm not really sure. It didn't do like it was supposed to do, but we'll try this one right here. No, that wasn't it.
That's not it.
But it's like, that was like...
Oh, heavens forbid. Is Daddy Ray listening?
I once heard Big Mo explaining that...
That's kind of like it.
So much for that, huh? I once heard Big Mo explaining that actually Mo was his initials because he had a long name that was hard to remember. And actually, he didn't know where they got the big idea from. In this case, they asked me if I remember this song. Don't ask me why.
Well, let's just sing it for them, Donnie. Here we go. Don Tomlin singing one of his own songs. I forgot the words of this tune.
I forgot the words of this tune. Sure hope I remember them soon. If I don't, I'll sing you some more time.
Oh, yeah.
And if it goes over quite well, who knows, man? Can't ever tell. I might just name it Mr. Calling It Mine. Oh, the song I don't remember, though I sure recall the blessing in my soul.
In my soul.
A wonderful song I'd love to sing. Only I could remember just how it goes.
Think about it.
That aren't there. Seems my mind just went out of here. If they lay under the table or floor. Being here, I'd rather be gone. Just my love, the music plays on. The next words out of my mouth could be nothing at all.
Woo!
Oh, the song I don't remember, though I sure recall the blessing in my soul. Wonderful song I'd love to sing. If only I could remember just how it goes.
Doing good so far, Donnie.
Oh, good, Donnie, come on.
You remember it.
See that lady on the front row, always there wherever I go. Sitting there quiet, never saying a word.
Not a sound.
Till one night the singing got sweet. She jumped her feet, requested some awful awesome I ain't never heard.
song I don't remember, though I sure recall the blessing in my soul. Wonderful song, I love to sing.
Donnie, I like that. And while he's doing that, after that, I want to ask y'all a question real quick.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. What is worse than a dinosaur with a toothache?
Oh.
Come on, think now. What's worse than a dinosaur with a toothache?
Me with a toothache.
No.
Well, I ain't got any teeth.
Really? You got fixadent. No, what's worse than a dinosaur with a toothache? If y'all don't know, I'll tell you.
You'll tell us.
A centipede with athlete's foot. That was a good one.
You're getting a laugh from back in the green room.
Yeah, the green room.
Our guest was back there. Told him not to eat all the donuts back there, so leave us some.
I never thought about
a centipede with athlete's foot. I mean, your world is so small, that's got to be miserable. Yeah. I mean, you're in a whole nother universe.
Yes,
from
I love it. Yeah, a dinosaur with a big old toothache, but can you imagine poor little centipede with athlete's foot? Right.
Then he become a butterfly one day, thanks to metamorphosis.
Oh, wow. Word.
Okay.
We are a higher calling
yes,
production.
We are.
Yes, we are.
We got it. Bottomless barrel jokes for you.
Wow.
If you got good jokes, send them to us.
Don't send them. I gotta tell mine. Don't send them.
Well, Ron, sing us a song. Lost. Are you lost?
No, I'm not lost. I'm saved.
Well, what is the song about?
Being lost in the presence
about
of the Holy
Ghost. About being filled with the Holy Ghost and carrying on.
Well, let's
speaking in tongues.
And, let's carry on with it.
If I told you I sing something that nobody else could see. If I told you that there have been some angels talking to me. Would you merely thank me foolish that my senses I had lost? No, I'm just lost in the presence of the sweet Holy Ghost. I'm lost in the presence of the sweet Holy Ghost. And each day he draws me closer to the one I love. If you're scared of my religion, then you better not get too close. Cause I'm lost in the presence of the sweet Holy Ghost. Well, I'm lost in the presence of the sweet Holy Ghost. And each day he draws me closer. Yeah.
see if you think it's blasphemy. Cause dancing in the feet, I can hardly hear you talking. I ain't listening very well, cause I'm plugged into his power and I'm about to have a spell. Said I'm lost in the presence of the sweet Holy Ghost, and each day he draws me closer.
He's not going to make you walk out in the street and get run over by a car or nothing like that.
Yes.
That would be wrong.
No, that's the Holy Ghost not ain't wrong. So,
but don't be afraid of the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost has been in this program.
Amen.
And right now,
thank the Lord.
And if he can hear us down in the green room, we got a special guest here. A special friend.
Yes, we do.
We're going to ask him to come out and take a seat. We've been knowing this fellow for a long time. He's still down there eating donuts, I think.
So
here he our friend, Reverend Pastor Guy Heath.
Yep.
Tell me
thank you.
Doctor, and Professor Guy Heath. I mean, he's all that. Better get the.
Let me get over here closer to that pipe.
In the way.
See this pipe here?
Yeah.
Pull it out.
There you go.
Pull it out of the fountain.
Yeah, let's put it on the other end.
Yeah. There you go. That's good.
You know what? Thank you for welcoming me to this great program. And I was so impressed, Donnie.
Oh, really?
With your song. You know what? When I was listening to the test pressing of this, that Pat gave to me to listen, I began to think what we need to do. Donnie writes some really colorful songs, and he has written a song about being so open-minded all your brains are going to run out. And what is really cool, I have written a couple of novelty songs, and Renee has, I don't know if you all know this, she has dogs that sing along. And let me ask you this, those of you that are watching right now, if you could get a song about, you can't remember what the words are, if you could get a CD about that, a CD about your brains falling, a novelty CD, and watch Renee's dog sing along, wouldn't that be a terrific CD?
Calling you or calling me.
Let me tell you what I came up with, Donnie. And you know what I'd like to do? Let's have some fun out of this. Ron, I know you've got a direction you want to go, but the people don't want to hear about me. They want to hear about the Lord Jesus. They want to hear about having fun. Get out your pen, Donnie. Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to ask the folks that are watching right now to help us write a song. Now, years ago when I was traveling in evangelism, and years ago when I was doing television, every week, I would have folks call in suggestions for songs, okay? And we're going to write some songs live. Donnie is a great songwriter. Say amen, Donnie.
Amen, Donnie.
Okay. Hey, here is something
amen, boy.
I was thinking about. Listen to this.
He's down there. He just can't see.
It's time. Well, Donnie, wave a hand or something. We'll see.
Here's his
over there. Yeah. Okay. Anyway, listen to this. And this applies to some of those of you that are watching right now. You have had a setback. Take a step back. It's a setup for a step up. Isn't that great?
Oh, yes.
And you are on track
for a comeback.
Wonderful.
Now I'm going to say that again. We're going to sing
the chorus.
Yeah, this is the chorus. And then what we're going to do is, I want those of you that are watching, get in touch with us. We're going to finish this song. I think it should go something like this. Doom, da boom, boom, doom, da boom, boom, doom, doom, boom. You've had a setback. Take a step back. It's a setup. For a step up. You are on track. For a comeback. If you're set back, just take a step back. It's a setup. For a step up. You're on track. For a comeback. And then you guys finish it for us. Jesus is our backup.
There
you
go.
Let's do that one again. Those of you that, now, you can't take that copyright because this is officially now been copyrighted by me. I'm a licensed copyright person. Okay.
I thought I wrote faster than that.
Okay, let's try it again. You've had a setback.
Setback.
Take a step back. It's a setup for a step up. See, what we've got to realize, Ron, every time something happens to us, God isn't taken by surprise. He knows what's going on.
Amen. Word for the
God isn't wringing his hands in heaven right now saying, oh dear, what am I going to do with coronavirus?
Yes.
God isn't wringing his hands right now saying, oh dear, what am I going to do with riots in the streets?
Yes. Wow.
God isn't wringing his hands right now saying, what is going to happen to the church with the hurricanes that are coming into our part of the country? You know what God's doing? He says, child, get into the 91st Psalm. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust.
Yes.
In other words, surely he's going to deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence.
That's
okay. So if you're experiencing... And see, Ron, a lot of the folks, Renee, some of our friends that are watching right now, you know, they've lost their jobs.
Oh, yeah.
Here's the troublesome part to me. 40 million Americans who used to have a job.
Right.
These aren't people that didn't have a job.
My daughter.
40 million people in America don't have a job to go to Monday morning.
Right.
And they say, wow, what a setback.
It
is a setback.
Yeah, setback.
Guess what? The setback, when you have a setback, take a step back. I'd like to see that choreographed.
That's good. That's good.
When you have a setback, take a step back.
Ooh, Lord, I like that.
And realize it's a setup. Glory to God.
That's good.
For a step up. God is not going to take you back to the same place you have been. God is going to elevate you through this moment, through this time. You watch. God's got something big in mind.
Ooh,
you talk about a man that went through a setup, Joseph. You talk about a setback. Here he was favored, blessed of his father. He ends up in a pit. Blood stains his garments. They sell him to the caravan going through town. By his brothers. He ends up in jail. He is called into the chief's house to take care of the house. He is housekeeper. The wife lies on him and says, you know, he was trying to make time with her. And all of that time he goes back to jail. It's a setup for a step up. Step way up. Here you are, a pit possessor. And the next day, you're in the palace. Glory to God.
Wow,
it's a setup for a step up, and you are on track for a comeback.
Yes.
Oh, my. You know what? Some of you help us write this song. Who knows? This might be a number one song.
And I know it'll bless a lot of people.
You sure will.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you sit down right now and write to us?
Well,
you know what? If I had a keyboard, Pat, one of these times, I want you to bring your keyboard here because I love to write songs live. People call in, and I mean, I have done that for years on television. And when God begins to move like that, you'd be surprised. I have songs right now that are being sung in different parts of the country that were created in moments like this. And so, I'm going to give this to you again.
Okay, let's go.
Make sure you have that. And let the Holy Spirit begin to inspire you. Donnie, I know your mind is turning down there. Okay? Here we go.
You're experiencing a setback.
Setback.
Take a step back.
Step back. Oh, okay.
I got it.
Realize it's a setup.
Setup.
For a step up. You know, hey, let me preach just a little while longer. I don't know how much more time I've got here, Pat. But let me just tell you this. The devil always, 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 you ought to write this down too, Donnie, always overplays his hand. He always overplays his hand. The Apostle Paul said, if he had known, he never would have crucified the Lord of glory. I want to shout right now.
Yes.
If the devil knew what was going to happen when they spiked the hands of Jesus, if the devil knew what was going to happen when they platted the crown of thorns on Jesus' head, did you know Jesus bore the curse for us?
Yeah.
And the devil, that curse that God, the devil wanted to put on you, Jesus took that curse. The devil didn't know it.
Yeah, that's right.
It was a setup.
Woo!
God set him up for us to have a step up. The
devil was set up.
Yes.
The devil was set up.
Yes.
Wow. And what's happening?
He don't like that. That's why he's so mad today.
I know. And here's the tricky thing about it. Those of you who've lost your job, you're on track for a comeback.
Ooh, amen. I like that.
Those of you that are struggling financially, you're on track for a comeback. Glory to God. And we're going to pray in a little while. I know you've already prayed, but we're going to pray for folks that have lost their 40 million people.
Yes.
And those of you who have lost your businesses.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because of the riots. Even though you're not insured, God's going to bless you.
It's a setup for a step up.
My daughter is on furlough till July the 31st.
My.
And it's been there since March.
So if you've had a setback, you know what? Everybody who's watching right now, and you've had a setback, get in touch with us.
That's good.
You've had a setback. My, it hurts.
Yeah.
Doesn't it hurt?
Yes, it does.
You cry hot salt tears on a time like this. You've had a setback.
Yes, you have.
Take a step back. And realize it's a setup.
Yes.
Everybody
that's
go.
Good.
It's a setup for a step up.
That's good.
And you are on track for a comeback.
Oh, I like that.
Can I say something here?
Sure.
We've got just a few more minutes, and I would like to close it out, and I would like for you to help them sing this song. This song is perfect for this. Donnie wrote it. Only God can make America great again. You think you can do that?
You know what? America's on track for a comeback.
That's right.
Pray for your president. Pray for President Trump.
President Trump, we're praying for you.
Yes, yeah. We are.
I pray for you every day.
Yes, we are.
I've been saved since the 80s, and I've prayed. I learned to pray when I became a Christian, to pray for our leaders. And I've done it faithfully. You know, didn't care who was in office. Mm-hmm. I prayed for them. But it's a tough job.
All right, let's do this song.
Yes, let's do this song. We got just enough time.
President Trump is here. Keep praying for the people who seem to think they found a better way. Their freedom to reject the Lord puts us more in bondage every day. And the more we move away from God, more our country will just fall apart. We should get down on our knees and ask the Lord to really change our hearts. Oh Lord, all I pray, help us get back to the values for which we all should stand. Only God can make America great again. This is the best place on earth. Devil's trying to tear it down.
Come on, God, into your head.
Go back to church on Sunday and try to get a friend to tag along. This country would be a lot better if all of us would sing some gospel songs. Get back into the Bible and start a
everybody's
good night, everybody, from our Higher Calling Productions.
See you next week.
You be blessed.
Amen.
7 o'clock.
Good night.